This is an experimental arrangement for comparing EMF of two cells using potentiometer. This is a potentiometer you can see. In normal potentiometer, we have 8 to 10 turns of the wire. You can check here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 turns of the wire there. Larger be the length of the wire, smaller be the least count, because potential gradient calculated for a potentiometer measures least count of potentiometer. Let's see how to connect it. You see, this is a positive terminal where all positive terminals are coming together. This is positive terminal coming from copper vessel, that is a Daniell cell. This is positive terminal is coming from carbon rod, which acts as positive terminal for Leclanché cell. This is Leclanché cell, this is Daniell cell. Negative electrode is used as zinc in both. It has got electrolyte as NH4Cl. In this case, electrolyte is dilute sulfuric acid. Now this one more positive terminal is connected to your battery eliminator. Negative of battery eliminator is connected to the key, and key is connected to the rheostat, and rheostat is finally connected to another terminal, right? Here these two cells are connected with two-way keys. You can see two-way keys. It has got three terminals. So when we plug in this side, this will connect your cell. You can check that is Daniell cell is being connected. When I plug in key this side, then this is connecting your cell called Leclanché cell, right? The central part is connected with a galvanometer and jockey. You see, through a resistance we have connected here a galvanometer, and this is a jockey, right? Into this resistance box, even if you want, you need not to connect with the circuit, because this is required only when deflection in galvanometer is pretty large. When you see if galvanometer needle is steadily moving left or right, then there is no need of resistance box. However, connecting resistance box in series with galvanometer does not affect your reading. Now see how to take measurements. First, you have to connect with one cell. Suppose this is I have plug-in. So which cell is connected? Leclanché. Before starting your experiment, you first check whether your circuit is working properly or not. How do you check it? Bring jockey in contact near to the positive terminal of the wire and check the deflection in galvanometer. Is it is towards right of the zero? Now bring it in contact with the negative terminal, right? It deflects towards left of the zero. Once you see the deflection in galvanometer is in two opposite directions, it means circuit is working. So now you can go ahead to find the null point for Leclanché cell. And remember, while you are trying to find the null point, never scratch jockey on the wire. Don't be very hard. You can just touch jockey, because metallic end of the jockey, it will show deflection. So touch here, then touch here, deflection in opposite direction, move to the next wire, right, then left, then right, then left, then right, left, and then here it is left. So it must be somewhere here. Check. Right. 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 So it is somewhere here. You can locate easily. You can see null point is there. Right? So this is the position. How do you find the position or length of the wire till here? You can keep even scale to this point. But remember, this is coming out to be 100, 200, and then 295.5. You see, how do I calculate? Starting from where there, positive end, 100 completes here. Then 101 starts from here, 200 here. Third, it is 201 and onward it comes here. So it is here, that is 95.5 as I shown you in the reading. So you have to remember while you are taking null point length that first, third, fifth, seventh and ninth wire you will start seeing the scale from that side. For second, fourth, sixth, eighth and tenth you will take your reading from this side. Is that clear? Similarly, you can disconnect this cell by removing key from the two-way key. So I am removing from here and plugging into the first gap. When I plug in into this gap, you see it is connected with Daniel cell. I am inserting this electrode here. Every time when you complete your reading, please remove this zinc rod because it reacts with dilute sulfuric acid and it slowly and slowly size reduces. So be careful. So right now I have inserted because I am going to take the null point. Before taking null point, follow the same procedure. Check the galvanometer deflection. When I bring it in contact to positive terminal, it is right. When we go here, it is left. So find out null point. Null point is checking here, here. No, here. So here, it must be somewhere here. Let us check. Yes. See, it is the null point. So you can take reading for this. It comes out nearly 15.7. That is 215.7. Third round is, we are looking at this scale. Right? So you have got null point L1 as 295.5 and this is 215.7. Correct? Now I will tell you on the board how to calculate and compare EMF of two cells. For other readings, remember you have to change the position of rheostat. Change the position of rheostat little so that current in the main circuit will change. Follow all the steps as I did. For Leclanché first, then Daniel cell. And similarly, you take 4 to 5 readings to complete this experiment. See, this is an observation table. You can create one more column for ammeter reading. Ammeter reading you can check in ammeter. And it should be constant while you are finding null point for cell 1 and cell 2. As I shown you experiment that we have taken reading for E1 and E2 both. So you have just simply to use formula E1 over E2 is equal to L1 over L2 and ratio comes out 1.37. That's how you can compare EMF of two cells for taking second, third and fourth reading. Not much effort you have to do. Every time you move rider of the rheostat little towards one direction, then automatically the ammeter reading will change. Keep it fixed. And again find null point for cell 1, E1, write it down here, then null for cell E2, write it down here and find null point and find the ratio. When you find the ratio for all readings, it should come out approximately the same. There may be a variation of say 0.1 or 0.2. That's how you can experiment for comparing EMF of two cells.